Machiavelli Mills TV. So look, man, when I was in college, right, you know, I went to school at Mississippi Valley State University, and a lot of people that never been to Chicago, Illinois, they always get questions. You know, they see stuff going on in the news, they see all the stuff that happened on, you know, all on news and on the music videos or whatever, that they listen to the music videos, that the music from Chicago artists, and they wonder what it's like and all of that. So an older woman, she was a non-traditional student, she asked me, she say, Malcolm, you from Chicago. What gang were you in? What gang was you in when you was growing up? You was in a gang? I'm like, no, not at all. And she like, you from Chicago? You went in no gang? And I'm looking like, you don't got to be in no gang just because you from Chicago. And I told her, like, nah, I stayed clear from the gang activity all the way. I stayed clear from it. And here's the reason why I stayed away from gangs. Now, it could be an obvious reason that you all know. Y'all get a feel for my personality from the stuff that I talk about on this channel, from how I present myself. I'm not no street dude at all. I'm from the hood, lived in the hood for majority of my life, but I'm not no street dude, right? I was never willing to risk my freedom for another group of men. I just was never willing to do that. I was never willing to put my life on the line every single day unnecessarily. I just wasn't ready. I was not never willing to do that. And also, I came from a home with structure, right? My mother didn't play that, for real. She wanted me to be a leader, not a follower. Because a lot of the dudes I grew up with, a lot of them I grew up with, they was all in gangs, right? I got family members that's in gangs, or people that family that's gang affiliated or whatever, right? But I knew that wasn't the path for me. I knew that wasn't the road for me to go down. At the end of the day, I knew it was two possible outcomes from the lifestyle, the gang lifestyle. Either you're going to go to jail, you're going to spend majority of your life in jail, you're going to do some significant time, but not a whole lot, or you're going to do a small amount of time. Either way, even if you do a small amount of time, you will have something on your record, which is going to prevent you from getting a good job to provide for your family going forward. I didn't have time for that, right? Another thing, you could end up worse. You can end up 6 feet under, right? You could end up in somebody's casket. And I'm like, nah, I love life. I want to live for a very long time. I got a daughter that I got to provide for. I got cousins and little cousins that look up to me that I got to make sure they stay away from the nonsense and the foolishness. I want to live a long, prosperous, abundant life. I don't want to be out here getting taken out at a young age. I couldn't do it. And I knew that being a gang member meant that you got to be willing to ride out at any time. You got to be willing to stand on the block no matter what's going on. You could be in war with somebody. You got to be outside putting in work and all of that. And I was never going to be a dude that was willing to put my life on the line every single day unnecessarily for some nonsense, for some BS. I couldn't do it. I knew also that when you were part of a gang in Chicago, Illinois, I'm going to speak on Chicago because I only know the gang politics in Chicago, Illinois. I'm not familiar with gang politics anywhere else but here. But I know here, if you are part of a gang, right, it is going down out here. You got to live on an island because you're going to have enemies in different neighborhoods, different territories. People, you're not going to be able to go down certain streets. You're not going to be able to go to certain malls, certain stores, because you in a rival neighborhood. You're going to have to worry about looking over your shoulder every single day. And I look over my shoulder anyway because I'm just a person that don't want to be caught from behind. I don't want to be nobody sneak up on me to do nothing from me. I'm a person that's aware in general. But I can't imagine a person that's having to be aware because I'm in a gang and I don't know if this person's out to get me, that person out to get me. It's people that really live on islands in Chicago because they so heavily into the gang street life. Like, they can't even go out in certain public functions that a lot of people love going to. They can't go to the Bud Billiker parade. They can't go to the parade. If they got kids, they can't take their kids to the parade. Because unfortunately, it's somebody that's going to see them. And when they see them, it's on sight. No questions asked. No, it's people that probably don't even care about the fact that the person might have their kids with them. If you in a gang, and you out here, and you got to be out here in it if you in a gang, too, in Chicago. Like, there's no way around it, right? And when you out here in it, you put yourself, you become a target. Anywhere you at, or you can possibly put your kids or your family in harm's way, right? And it's like that never was something that I ever wanted to be a part of. Like, no lie, it's crazy. My boy, right? He got a friend that's a hooper that's from a dangerous neighborhood that everybody know about, but they into it with different hoods. And he was driving, my dog was driving this dude home after they playing basketball. And the dude into so much stuff, he got so much stuff going on in the street. His hood has so much stuff going on in the street, he had to tell my boy, look, don't go down that street. Go down this one, come back up this way. Don't go down that street, go down that way, come back down. Like, all of that, like, man, you can't even live a regular life because you always worried about who out to get you. Can't even enjoy no type of public event because you just looking like, is this dude looking at me funny? Do he know me? Is he from this neighborhood? Is he from that neighborhood? All of that. Like, and I'm growing up. This is the 2020s. Like, it's crazy because gang banging was worse in Chicago in the 80s and 90s. Chicago always been gang infested. A lot of the big gangs that a lot of people know about was started here. So it was a point where in the 90s, it was going up. It was going down. Like, I mean, you couldn't be caught wearing certain colors in certain neighborhoods. And Chicago don't even run off the color code like currently as much as like it did at one point. It don't run off the color code like LA do or California does. It doesn't. You know, it's about how you wear your hat, how you cock your hat and all of that now. But that's why I'm either wearing my hat straight back or straight forward. Cause I ain't trying to get even think I'm with none of that. But yeah, man, like you. Man, it's just a whole different thing, man. It's being a gang member here is not something you can play with. You can't do it because it's fashionable, because it's trendy. Can't become a part of it and say, okay, I'm done with it now. Like, nah. Once you in it, you in it. And if they know you in it, and no matter where you at, hey, you liable to whatever happens. And it's a sad reality, and I never wanted to be a part of that. For real, I done seen dudes get jumped on the bus on public transportation for being in the wrong gang or the wrong being from the wrong gang in the wrong neighborhood. Seriously, somebody catch you on a bus, they see your face or they see you from Instagram from somewhere hanging with these dudes. They know you in the same gang, you same as that other person that they got beef with. They on you, or you from the hood that they beefing with. They on you instantly. And I was like, nah, bro, I can't do it. For real. You can get caught in the wrong neighborhood and probably just be, and this is the sad part about it. You can get caught in a neighborhood and you could be the cousin of somebody that's real gang affiliated. And if they know you that person's cousin, you could be in some dangerous trouble, which is why people just need to stay away from the gang life in general. Man, and the old heads will tell y'all, all that stuff ain't worth it, man. It's not. Because dudes out here losing their life left and right. And it's kids killing kids. 15, 16 years old, 14 years old, taking other kids' lives. All for the name of being super prideful and being tough and like poking out your chest for a name. Like, that ain't worth it. It ain't. And again, I can't be in nobody's jail cell. Nobody telling me when I can go to the bathroom, when I can eat, when I can call my family, when I can see my family. I can't, you know, I be around and my woman can't be around me at all. Like, it's crazy. You in there with another man and all, like, no, bro, it's not going down like that. I could never do it, man. But it's a lot of people that that have succumbed to the gang life and it went bad for them. But that's why I never became a part of it, because I never wanted no parts of none of the other stuff, none of the stuff that I described. Machiavelli Mills TV. Peace.